Good morning, you guys. To my returning subscribers, welcome back. If you're new here, I hope you enjoy the video and eventually choose to stay. You guys already know I like to check out new places, look around, see what's new. This day I saw something called the Taste Museum. I was very curious because what's a taste museum? So I went to check it out with my brother. Apparently it tells the evolution of taste. Yep. You know what, I don't want to give too much, so let's just check it out together. Hi guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Shout out to Shishok, Jaja suggested that we do a comparison video between China and Nigeria. Come on, it's hard to put Nigeria side by side with China.
Turn it down.
They can't hear me. Thank you. It's hard to put Nigeria side by side with China. It's very hard because you almost see no good thing about Nigeria.
Facts.
Instead of that, all we're going to do is we're going to say five things we like about China and five things we hate about China in comparison to Nigeria. Do you want to start?
You start.
First thing I like about China is the organization. It's like, you know, when we were taught in high school, division of labor. Yeah, that division of labor, they do it here and they follow it to the latter, in the sense that everybody knows what they're supposed to do. And everybody does it, and they do it, and they're held responsible for it. So if anything is wrong in one area, they know who to go to and who to, like, you know, address.
Exactly. She said it. Very organized. Like, one thing I pick from China,
you see, whatever you want,
it's available.
Anywhere you are, it's available.
Yeah. That's so true.
To your doorstep.
It may be hard to find it.
Don't you have this device? Your phone?
But it's always available.
Damn.
Oh, third thing I like about China is their patriotism. Well, their patriotism stems from the fact that their country is actually working. They're very patriotic. Before a Chinese person will have an iPhone, they already have Huawei. And when you ask a Chinese person to choose between China and America, for instance, they're always going to choose China.
I was trying to remember one thing I like about China. I remember
nothing like, this work is for man, this work is for woman. You will see them working like, not like Nigeria.
Like highest, if you are not able to do some things, that's cool. You don't know how to do it, you don't have the strength to do it.
Different.
But you can't say women don't do this one, men don't do this one. You, ladies and men, as long as you are capable of doing a job, you do it. Another thing I like about China is how they are always developing. Chinese people are very hardworking. They are always doing one thing or the other to push them one step forward. Today you can be passing a street, tomorrow the street looks different from how it was yesterday. Yeah. And they've started on that one in another side.
They put their mind on something. They say they're going to do this, they're going to do this.
Yeah, and they don't stop until they've completed it.
Last year, when the coronavirus started, I think around February last year, right? Or something like that. January, February, March, one of those 3 months. They built a big ass house in some days, man. Yeah, then.
We're in Nigeria now. Do you know that in China there are some places that mimic world known tourist centers? For instance, about a few years ago, I went to Dalian. There's this place in Dalian called Venice City. Literally looks like Venice. I don't know how they do it, and apparently that's not the only one. There are so many others. Can you imagine that?
One thing I like about China, I like it, but somehow the thing to vex me, it pisses me off. There's nowhere in China that you enter that there's no camera, and there's no how that camera is not working.
Yeah, yeah, there's CCTV everywhere.
Every.
On the road, even here, everywhere. What do you want to do? There's a CCTV camera everywhere, and it's working. And when they need it for something, they are going to use it, and they will exactly. So if you commit an offense and they need you for something, they can find you.
They don't play with their rules.
They obey their rules. They are very strict.
Strict as fuck.
And I think that's why corruption is not as rampant. There's definitely corruption. I mean, there's no country where there's no corruption. But corruption is not as rampant here as in many other places. The thing I like about China is that food is cheap relative to the amount of money they make. Food is actually very cheap. You can use 20 kwai to eat. 20 kwai is like how much in Naira right now? About 1.4.
That's 1,530.
Okay, so 1.5. Balanced diet. I feel like we said more than 5.
I think those are kind of like the only things.
They
have some fucked up roads.
Yeah, they have some fucked up roads, but most of their roads, I mean, compared to Nigeria,
Let's say their roads, 7 over 10.
Their roads are good. Maintenance is one thing that they don't joke with. So even when it gets bad, they're working on fixing it. They have a very stable economy. A few months ago, the dollar to yuan was 7.2, 3. But as at the last time I went to the bank, it was back to 6.5. How did they do that? So now things we don't like about China.
Actually, just one thing I don't like about China. Just one. Literally just one. The way they are strict. I don't know what I should call it. They are just too strict. Their camera is annoying. They don't have privacy in China.
You hardly have any privacy.
Suspect them. You can never trust. You can never trust them.
Something I don't like about China. China is not home. There's a little bit of racism here, and that's not nice.
There are still some provinces in China that have very bad racism. Places like Shanghai, Guangzhou,
Beijing.
The racism there is not that bad because they see a lot of foreigners, but. See these other small towns.
I remember one time this old man, I think, yeah, they were really old. They saw me walking down a path. As soon as they saw me, the man held his wife and they started running. I mean, they were very old. They looked like grandparents or something. But yeah, it can feel some type of way sometimes. Another thing I don't like about China. I don't like the language barrier. This is so hard. I'm always fried. That's all. I can say this though. I miss fried yam. Fried yam like crazy. It's very expensive. I don't know if it was enough or up to 5. But yeah, that's all. That's the end of this video. And I hope you enjoyed it. Please remember to like, subscribe, and comment what you thought about this video.
Hey yo, peace out.
Thank you so much. Bye.